And we're gathered here today on this very sad day to pay our respects to my brother Madhu and the baby of the family. So the first person who's going to talk is going to be our Baba from Pittsburgh, and he'll be on Zoom.
Yeah,
who's going to speak is going to be Madhu's son, Kosh, and I'll let Madhu and Kosh talk.
Sitting there writing still. I stayed up pretty late last night trying to figure out what to say. But thanks everybody for joining us. And I wish everybody could be here in person, but thanks for the people that are here on Zoom. Not usually a person with a lot of words. He loved to tell people his memories of me as a child, and I'll share a couple of those. He loved to tell people about when I was a child and he took me to an Orioles game. He said I spent the entire game trying to get the mascot's attention by screaming Oriole bird over and over. I'm sure much to the dismay of the people sitting around us. He also loved to tell people about when he took me to my first concert and I got so excited that I wet myself while sitting on his shoulders. He loved to tell my friends that when he met them. I'll miss his sense of humor and his endless generosity. I'll miss his cooking and I'll miss throwing pasta noodles at the ceiling with him to see if they're done. As far as I've gotten in my writing, but I love my dad very much and I'll miss him very much. And thinking about everybody else too, whose life was affected by my dad and who spent time with my dad. I know everybody loves him very much and I know that he knows that everybody loves him very much. Thank you.
So the next person who's going to speak is somebody that's very special to the whole family, and that is our beloved niece, Natasha, and she's going to be on Zoom.
Thank you.
next person who's going to speak is going to be our sister, Santi. And for me, it's always been Aka. So in our language, that means the older sister. So, and she'll be on Zoom.
Surrounded by a beautiful family. I wish that we knew
So our next person is going to have a few words. It's going to be our brother-in-law, Milan. So our next speaker is going to be Sean. So Sean is the one who has organized this whole Zoom meeting together, and it's taken a lot of time in the last few days to put all this together. And Sean, you are always been somebody who Uncle Madhu has looked up to. So I'm, you know, very special here. I'll turn it over to you, Sean.
When I was growing up, my family was going through our own crisis, and
Gugu was his favorite, and he absolutely made him turn him into a Cowboys fan out of all the family members in his family. So, Gugu. Bush. Neil, I'm going to turn it over to you. Have a few.
Sandy, we call her Uncle, we call her Sweet Monster.
our next person who's going to speak is our, what we call our adopted brother, is Gopi, Gopi Dandamuni. Gopi spent a lot of time with the family from his high school years onwards, and he is a brother to us, and I'll let Gopi have a few words.
Thanks, Sri.
Scorpions with my brothers, one of his favorite songs, and if people picked up some of the lyrics, it was about brotherhood, and now it's my opportunity to talk and say a few words about my brother. Madhu, the baby of the family and our baby brother. And you were also the baby to many of the people that we were associated with since we grew up and also growing years. But in many ways, you were the big brother to all of us. Madhu, the meaning in our Telugu language means honey. Yes, you're the honey that comes from the nectar of the bees, and you're the sweetest honey to everyone you have ever been associated with. You had such a big heart, and one that had no boundaries. You took everyone that you knew, starting with family, friends, and total strangers you didn't know into your life, and made them happy, and made them strong, and made them feel loved. Your personality was one that radiated with openness and playfulness. Boy, did you love to banter with everybody and raise an ire, only to come back and say that I love you, and then give them a hug or say high five. You loved to laugh and make others laugh. You always had a quick comeback or a quip or some one-liners that made people stop dead in their tracks. We have a very common friend named Ann back home. And he would love to banter with her because, again, she was another Steelers fan, just like my relatives in Pittsburgh. But they would go back and forth for hours about the Steelers and the Cowboys. Now, I'm going to share some things about Madhu that many people probably don't. He also had a very sensitive and caring side. My sister spoke about the other issues with my brother, but I'm going to share my experiences with him from a more personal and more more sensitive side of him. He loved his family so much, and he took after our parents in many ways. He had the utmost respect for our father, and would always talk to me about how such a great man he was, and that he could never fill his shoes, and how he had persevered by coming to this country in 1963, and not only excel in the professional arena, but mainly with his family. We would have so many conversations, whether we'd be here in Dallas or back at home, and he would always talk to me about how Dad was great, and that he made sure that all the relatives were taken care of, and how proud he was of your dad for providing not only to the immediate family, but also to the extended family by sponsoring many of our cousins and family members to be able to come and start a new career and a new life in this country. And not only did he talk about your great achievements, but one thing he would always reminisce is the last couple of times, or the last time they had gone to India, and we visited Tataya and Diamond and Berlin. Okay. And one thing he always used to talk to me about was the memory that he had sitting there with Tataya on the outside bench and rolling fresh tobacco into cigars. And the two of them couldn't really converse with each other because they didn't understand the language. Tataya didn't speak English, but they didn't speak Telugu. But there's this memory etched into me where they would just sit there and he'd ask Tataya to do it all over again. He must have been maybe around 10 years old at that time. And ask him to roll another one. Tataya had the most amount of patience and do it all over again. He also had his way to bond with Nainama. The other part of it was he had such a great admiration for where the whole family has come from. And one of the things that he always used to talk to me about was the background of agriculture. And maybe that is why the family has gone into the agriculture business and other arenas. Not only did he talk about spending time, and never really got to understand about the farms, but he enjoyed watching nature by learning, watching cows getting milk, or the bullock carts. So he had a great admiration for where the heritage and lineage came from. In the professional arena, Dad, he always felt that you were the best, you were the greatest person around. The one thing he would always tell me was, I could never be the chemist in this family, nor could I be able to replace the chemistry portion of the business. Boy, did you guys butt heads together. But when you have two people that are so driven for excellence, what else do we expect? Both of you had such great respect and admiration for all of your accomplishments that you would, even until the last time, he would always have conversations with my father late at night, whether it be about business, whether it be about family, whether it be about life in general.
was, after all, my dad's baby. And as for mom, he was the baby of the family. He knew how to trigger her in many ways, and the love and bond that they shared was absolute, and it cannot be put into words. You were her pride and joy. Yes, you used to drive her crazy with things, but then that wouldn't be you if you did not do that. You loved her dearly and would always talk to me about how she was so special and was the greatest mother in the world for all the sacrifices that she has made for the family, but also for being one of the hardest women that you ever knew. The memories of you coming home and the sheer joy she would have of seeing you would radiate throughout the house. We all knew when you were coming home, because she would be preparing your favorite dishes. She would also make sure that you're very taken well care of. And just like you, he gained the insight of taking care of people and feeding people and making sure that they're fed was from a mother. Your heart is as huge as hers, and she loved taking care of you. There are other bonds you have both shared in the business arena, as we were all in the family business together, with mutual admiration and respect. Since you and mom were the two people from the business side, and my sister, my dad, and I were from the scientific side, you had a special bond with her that we couldn't tap into, because you both would be able to sit there and talk about the accounting, the business, the finance, which some of us was not our arena. He would also recall our times to me about the times that he spent with going to Gwendolyn and Vigiard and spending time with Amama and also with Maui at the theater and also with Petima and Hyderabad. For Madhu, it was about memories, and it was about cherishing those memories and never letting go of those memories. He was very, for him, heritage and lineage and bondage was very, very important. That was something that he kept very close to his heart. There was interaction between my parents and him on a daily basis. He would call at all hours of the night, but then again, they could never get angry with him. After all, he was the baby of the family, okay? For our sister, yes, you both were salt and pepper. You both took care of each other from an early age. There are so many fond memories that she has of you, as well as you have of her. The one thing that he would always tell me was, I wish we can help her and make her happy while she was dealing with the illness of Natasha. It used to bother him to no end that, we couldn't find a cure to help Tasha get better and be well. Growing up, all of our friends used to adore him. Not only would, would Madhu be included in all their activities, they would actually, be part of their lives. Over the past 23 years, when my sister's been dealing and Melon have been dealing with Natasha's health issues, he would sit down with me when I visited or call me on the phone and say, hey, what's going on? How's Tasha doing? How's Melon doing? How's Akka doing? What can we do to make it better? And he would always talk about the boys and, how are the boys doing? And always looking out to see and make sure that everyone was, doing okay. He loved you very much, Akka, and you were his pride and joy. He loved all of our family, and would ask me about Millen. And the one thing that used to bother him was he wished he had much closer ties with Millen. And yes, it did bother him, but it was something that he learned to live with. He took care of her in many ways, and one special moment I will share with everybody was one time that they went to Brazil years ago when Baba and Pini were there, and apparently they were on the beach, and some stranger pickpocketed my sister, and he took off, running after the pickpocketer, into these streets of Brazil where nobody knew where he was going, but sure enough, he got the purse back. And got back to make sure my sister was okay. That was the thing about him. He was always thinking about others than himself. As for Adon, Natasha, what can I say? You were his joy, he respected you and would always tell me how very smart and beautiful you were. And he felt that you needed to be treated like an adult rather than a child. And he would do things to incorporate that into your life, such as taking to the casinos, or going out to the ball games, or even when you're at home, as you mentioned, teasing you, bantering with you. He loved to play around with you and then come away shaking his head saying you're too much. He would turn around and say, he goes, she got me. He would talk to me about how he wished more than anything in this world that he could have, that you could have a normal, healthy life. He worried about you and your mom. For the twins, Nikki and Sean, you have so many fond memories of him. With Nick, it was always about sports, or mainly about sports. But it was also about, you know, from being a secondary father or brother or big brother. Not only did he come to all of your football games, but he would egg you on to become better and better. He saw something in you at an early age and would talk to me about often about how he could make you succeed in anything that you wanted. Sean, you're always, as we said, the Mandava boy, okay? And that was there since you were a little kid. And that was something that Madhu always used to talk to me about. Oh, Sean's not a big guy. He's the Mandava. No, he's both. And he was, you know, very proud about how smart and intellectual you were. And he has a lot of fond memories of all of you. Now, when it comes to our extended family, he loved Baba and Nick Sunil and the family of Sri and all of their families. As Baba and Sunil and Sri have shared their memories, he also has very fond memories of you. As we talked about, as I mentioned earlier, the fondest memory that he has is visiting Baba and Penny in Brazil. And for him, his wish was he could always, if he could go back, he would like to take another journey back to Brazil with you and your families. When Neil got sick a couple years ago, he would always call me and ask me, how is Neil doing? And make sure that Neil is well, taken care of. This is a big brother in him, looking after everybody. There were many times he would call me and say, hey, how's Neil doing? You know, what's going on? You know, where is his progress? What's going to happen? Yes, he was always concerned. Even though he probably not have been able to express it, I'm sharing this with you because these are things that he shared with me on a regular basis. To Bevika, Ba, Raghu, and Soja, there are a lot of fond memories, and especially about living in the Bronx and in the high rise. He loved Raghu and was his favorite. There are many pictures of Madhu, but one of us will all remember is Madhu having Raghu on his shoulders and running around. To our cousins everywhere in the world, he loved all of you. While he always didn't spend a lot of time with everyone, he always had his own share of memories and remembers everyone. If we ever got to sit down and talk, it would go for hours and hours, and it was always about family and extended family first. Ravi and Kavita, you both are here, and you're a big part of his life. Ravi, the times that you spent when you initially came to the United States and grew up with us in Maryland, and all the various parties, and the times that you also spent at Tinley Street, are things that he always had fond and memories of and cherished. And for him, you're very special to him, and it's always about that big, beautiful smile that you have. Kavita, he loved you and respected you. In the past few years, he knew you were the one person he could count on that would take care of him. Whenever Mom and I would ask to go get a medical checkup, he goes, nope, I'm gonna wait till I go see Kavita. She's the only one I'm gonna have to take care of me. His heart was so big and extended to all of his friends. He always made sure, that they were well taken care of. If someone didn't have a place to stay, he had them live at his house without blinking an eye, never asking for anything in return. Didn't care, if they couldn't pay rent, if they couldn't do anything. He just wanted to make sure that everyone was safe and comfortable. And this is his loyalty to his friendships. And if he made a friend, his friends lasted a lifetime. There are many people here, either virtually or in person, that have been friends with Madhu since childhood, and the list is long. When he made a friend, it was friend for life. He would always talk about the memories of this childhood, growing up in Tenley Street and going to Paint Brain, and then going to University of Maryland, and then also living in Columbia, and then in Annapolis, and then now in Dallas. So his friendship has, you know, touched many parts, and then some of his friends are now scattered across the country, like Matt Gallagher in California. But for him to go and visit them and spend time with them were his special bonds and special times. Are there times like he would go with April and Ryan and others to Mexico to go see their favorite band, Dave Matthews? I could go on and on and on, but all the friends for him were very special. And the last few days, watching the tributes coming in, has not only touched me very deeply, but has also touched the family very deeply about how much love he has for everyone, but also love for him. Now, it wouldn't go without saying, we're talking about how happy Madhu was. And for the Indian family friends that we have, there's been a common comment or thread that has come about, and that was about the last time they saw Madhu was at Nalini's wedding, and they all commenting about how happy he was. But let me share the other perspective for him. For him, that day was very special because he shared with me afterwards. He goes, Srinivas, he goes, these are the people that we grew up with since we were kids. When we were growing up in this country, the Indian society was what we had to grow up with. And to see everyone, and for him, in his mind, it was a reunion. To see all of the friends that we grew up with was something that he was very deeply touched and talked to me about constantly after that. The one special family that he has is the Kadali family. He was like the second family to him. He would always tell me that I'm not the auntie's favorite. Yes, you are Lata Auntie's favorite. He would talk about the younger years when our families would meet up every weekend and how much he loved Nalini. Madhu, now he can also visit our other friend up there. There are so many families we grew up with, as mentioned in delegate communities. It was a charm that he possessed and a smile that he had that touched everybody. Chandra is somebody who is very dear and close to him. It is a love and friendship that has spanned 30 plus years. And when you were sick, Chandra, he would call me almost every day and ask me, please take care of her. Whatever you do, please take care of her. And he wanted nothing but the best for you. And for you, he loved you and your family very dearly. Now I'm going to turn to something else. He had so many passions. As everybody heard, as he talked about football, but I'll get to that in a minute. The one passion that he had was cooking. He loved to cook. And the one thing I can tell you is when we had our family holiday get-togethers, if one of us decided we're going to make a dish or we're going to prepare something, it was like, nope, we can't do it. I'm the one who's going to, you know, it's not going to taste good. It's not going to be this. He would come in there and tease us about using cookbooks or using recipes or using utensils to measure and whatever. And he would always turn around and tell my sister and me, because you can't cook by the cookbooks. It's about taste, about feel and aroma. The only person he felt was better than him in cooking was our mother. He was very proud of his cooking because he learned a lot of things from growing, you know, working at Three Brothers from an early age. And learning the craft of cooking authentic Italian food from scratch that he learned from the Three Brothers and Mama, which for him was another family to him. So, at Madhu, yes, you were the master chef in the family. He had passion for dogs, and if he had, you know, when he came across dogs, whether it was his or others, he would take them and pet them and hold on to them. And I'll never forget the day, you know, when it was back in the 80s, and we were never allowed to have pets growing up. And here he comes home one day with his little black lab puppy that he named Princess. Sure enough, you know, Princess became part of the family. And in the end, Yes, it was my father who would spoil Princess, as well as all the other dogs that we ever had. Yeah, Madhu, you're not only a rebel, not only in your own ways, but also a trendsetter for this family. He was so torn when he lost his puppy, when he lost his dog Nibbles, and that is something that has bothered him deeply since. Now we'll get to his biggest passion, was football and his beloved Dallas Cowboys and Oklahoma Sooners. There are so many different stories to tell from childhood to now, but the one story I'll share with you is he made my mother a Cowboys fan, and he would invite my mom to come to Dallas and go to the games. And mom was talked to me about in two particular games in that, you know, in general. One was when my beloved team, the Redskins, came back in the last 2 minutes and scored two touchdowns to win on a Monday night game. It ate at him, but he would also say, congratulations, a better team won that night. The other game was against the other arch rival, the New York Giants. When we were down by 13 points, they came back and won the last 2 minutes. Now, Baba, you were asking, where does this passion from Dallas Cowboys come? Well, he was born in Stillwater, Oklahoma, and for him, these were things that he felt were very close to him. For him, his bond was about lineage and heritage, and for him, his birthplace was Stillwater, and that's where he had the passion for the Oklahoma Sooners, and also for the Dallas Cowboys. For me, the greatest memory that I have of going to all Redskins Cowboys game, for us, it was about sharing. We knew every year the Cowboys and Redskins played twice a year, once in Washington, once in Dallas. So as we moved to Dallas, I think about 10 or 12 years ago, and from that point on, we had a common understanding between the two of us. I come to Dallas, he would always take care of me and my friends that were going to come. When he came to Washington, it was mutually respected back to him. But the one greatest memory that I have is when we brought Tasha down to the game. She ended up sitting in between the two of us. And here she is, you know, in her cap, in her Redskins jersey and whatever. And, you know, initially started cheering on for the Redskins. And somewhere in the middle of the game, all of a sudden she's sitting there rooting for both the teams. And my brother and I just look at each other like, you know, looking at her and going, what's going on? And she just goes like this. And we just shake our heads and go, in total disbelief. Yeah, dude, you had that effect on Tasha. And then after the game, it didn't end with that. She bugged him and bugged him and bugged him until we walked out of that stadium to get him a Cowboys jersey. And he would say, why do you want a Cowboys jersey? He goes, you're a Redskins fan. And she goes, I don't care, I just want a Cowboys jersey. Sure enough, she made him go into the Cowboys store that day and get him a Cowboys shirt, which she still holds on to. As for the Oklahoma Sooners, that was his love of being from the state of Oklahoma. And the fond memory that I have is about 2 years ago, Oklahoma was trying to play for the national championship, needed to win to go to the championship. Tasha was at home, and he was there in Potomac watching the game with her. They took a little friendly wager, and of course, Madhu took the, you know, Sooners, and Tasha said, okay, I'll go with the other team. Well, unfortunately, the Sooners got their butts whipped that day. But it didn't end there. The rest of the weekend, she kept on asking him, pay up, pay up, pay up, pay up. Finally, he kept on saying, you're a pest. You're a brat. You wouldn't leave me alone. Finally, Sunday evening, he turns around and goes, here, take it and leave me alone. What does she do? Goes up and gives him a big old hug. Yes. Those are the special times and memories that he shared with her. The other thing I'd like to share and is with our friend Jay. Being from Oklahoma and your family having alumni from multiple colleges that are considered arch rivals for college football, he would always ask me, I wonder what Thanksgiving dinner is like at Jay's house with all of his people from Texas, Oklahoma, Texas Tech. And if I'm missing any other team, I'm sorry. But he was always curious. So the curiosity was something that kept him going. Now I'm going to get to some things, the special memories that Madhu and I shared with each other. Even though I may be the older brother, in many ways Madhu was a big brother from a young age. I had time, I mean, part of my life was spent in India and here. But when I came back in the teens, it was Madhu who took me under his wings. He would insist that I go with him to meet his friends and say his friends were my friends. There were so many things that he taught me in sports, education, life in general, and then later on in the professional realm. Sure, we had our shares of sibling fights, but at the end of the day, he was my kid brother and respected him. Could he be irritating? Sure, but in his heart, he felt he was trying to share his passions in sports, music, life, everything. There's nothing like being woken up from a deep sleep and all of a sudden having a pair of headphones on my head, and here he is cranking up the groups like Scorpions, Van Halen, and all these groups when we were growing up. And yes, those are the groups who did that have become some of my favorite artists. And I had all of your albums still with me. He also took me under his wings, would always say, I have your back. I was a skinny little uncoordinated kid, and he would spend hours with me teaching me the various sports. Not only the rules, but also how to compete and how to get better. In the process, he worked with me on my coordination, strengthening, conditioning, etc. We both loved football, and even though we both had teams that supported arch enemies, there was always this mutual respect for one another, not as kids, but as we grew older. When the other team won, we'd give a hug and say good game and say next time. The one I would like to share a couple things about how he had my back. There are some of us know about an incident that happened when we were in our teens. This was days when ponds used to get frozen, we'd all go out and play ice hockey. So there was one winter we were right out there playing ice hockey and I fell through the ice and I couldn't get out of the ice. When everybody else just froze, Madhu had the quick instinct to lie down on the ice and throw his hockey stick and try and pull me out. He got me out of that water, in that frozen water, and ran home with me. Yeah, Madhu, you had my back. And then the other thing I'm going to talk about is having the back is in the sports. We played football on the same team, and there are many people that are joining in on the virtual Zoom that are from the football team, friendships, and whatever. And we both played on defense. And if anybody understands the game, I played the defensive line, which is the front. He played in the back. Yeah, Madhu, you had everybody's back. Not only mine, but everybody else's back on the team. And we knew we could count on you. Not only did he teach me things in sports, but also in life and about treating people. There was a time, very long time ago, we had gone out for dinner. And when we finished paying the bill, he gave the waiter a hefty tip and I asked him why. And his response was, three of us, you take care of others and they will take care of you. And also we take care of others that are less fortunate than us. These words of wisdom, I still carry around with me. There are so many secrets that we share, but a deep mutual respect for one another. When I decided to join the family business on a part-time basis in 2003, it was him that took the countless hours teaching me and helping me to learn the ins and outs of the businesses. I owe so much of all of this to him for the education, the guidance, and above all, to excel, not only in my own professional realm of medicine, but also in our family business. We would have conversations, whether it come to Dallas, or whether it be at home, or whether it be late at night. The one thing I wanted to share was, in the last couple of months, it really got to the point where it was bugging him, where he was seeing our parents still working, and he was working with me on trying to figure out how we can get them to retire and let us take over the family businesses and continue on the tradition. Unfortunately, that dream never got realized. The other thing was that we were a team, and we were a great team together. Sure, we butt our heads, but when we knew when the projects needed to get done, it didn't matter if it was late at night, early morning hours, we worked together and we got it done. He took care of me in many ways, but as we talked about was our special bond was the Redskins Cowboys game. And there was one particular game that I'd like to share with everybody, and it was the Thanksgiving game a few years back here in Dallas. And I had had the opportunity to meet with the President Bush and his family, President Jr. Bush and his family, I came running back to my seat and said, Madhu, you know who I just saw? And he goes, who? And I said, President Bush and his family. What does he do? Nonchalantly puts his arm around me and he goes, you know, bro, you never know who you're going to meet, and I love you, bro. That was him taking care of everybody and making sure that everybody had a great time. My brother Madhu, you have such a beautiful son, Kosh. I see so much of him in you every day. I know he was your biggest, utmost pride and joy. You would always tell me that you just want to make sure that Kosh is taken care of for the rest of his life and that he wouldn't have to worry about anything. Kosh, your dad loved you very much, and for him, you were his inspiration. He wanted to see you succeed and always wanted the best for you. And he would always turn around and tell me, he goes, Srinivas, he goes, please take care of him. He goes, and he would always talk about how he wanted to make sure that your dreams get fulfilled. One thing he made me promise a long time ago was, he goes, if anything should ever happen, he goes, please take care of Kosh for me. Madhu, that was nothing that could be asked. And he would always talk about Kosh being the last Mandava boy and about how he has to carry on the tradition of the Mandavas. He was so proud of you, Kosh. Yes, my dear brother, I got your back, and I will make sure our son is very well taken care of. After all, a generation later in our Mandava family, another older brother gets to raise another brother's son. It will be my greatest pleasure, joy, and honor to raise your son. Excuse me. I miss you so much, my little big brother. And I tried so hard to make it through this illness of yours. And I'm so sorry that I feel like I failed you. And for that, I will live with that sorrow forever. One last thing I'd like to say is, you would always say, you know what time it is? That's right, Madhu. It's free bird. It doesn't matter if it's a short version or the long version. You are now free at last and free as a bird. I love you, Madhu. And rest in peace. I'm glad to see you again.
Thank you.
Our next speaker is going to be from the Kadali family. I don't know if Latha Auntie is going to speak or one of the girls are going to speak.
Thank you.
back on? Our next person who's going to speak is our cousin Vivica from Wisconsin. And then after that, we'll have two of us. we'll have some people from here.
I could see these qualities even when he was 8-9 years old. Our families used to spend so much time with them, with holidays and in summer. We used to spend so much time with them, and so yeah, and used to be proud to be part of the greatest Madhu Mandava. He carried them in his arms and on his shoulders, even there when they beat his head. He used to laugh at them and used to say, "Don't worry, they have strong hands." And he used to put them in the bag all around the neighborhood, showing them to all the neighbors, and used to be proud of them. So many times we played board games, eating pizza, and he used to tease his siblings, and he used to get a big laugh when they got annoyed. He used to play at the fireplace, near the fireplace, using conker toys, which was his favorite toys at the time, and the fisher toys. He used to roast the marshmallows, and he used to eat the glowy blue stuff, and he showed it to the kids. He was so happy spraying the water with the hose, and he used to have any excuse to do that. And Dallas Cowboys is another story. Everybody knows how he loves those Dallas Cowboys. He used to jump up on the sofa and also is very upset when they get lost. He was a true fan. He successfully made a real cowboy fan and bought all kinds of paraphernalia, which I still have. And I say how sweet he was to do all these things. He used to say, "Of course, they were fast. I am M&M. I'm supposed to be sweet." And yeah, we spent some time last year at Nikki's wedding, and he was asking about everyone, every single person in the family. How can we forget him? He was one of a kind. Even though he's gone, we keep him alive. Talking about him, remembering all the good times. We pray for you. Pray for all the people we left behind, especially
So I have so many great memories of Mother Mama. He was there from my earliest moments, and I remember him teasing Sandy Penny and Trina Mama and everyone so much, but he never actually teased me. He was always so protective of me, and I remember him taking my brother under his wing and carrying him around and teaching him about the cowboys. And I was always so appreciative of his attention and his protection. And I know that he's still protecting all of us now and still remembering all those small details that make us happy. I was there the day that he brought Princess home
Thank you, Susan Gravercat. We're going to have one of Madhu's closest friends here in Dallas come up and say a few words. Jay Smith.
Srini obviously didn't get my input on the list of songs here. Madhu and I shared a strong love of Led Zeppelin, and I think you know that, so there would have been a Led Zeppelin song there. Probably I didn't let that slide. For y'all that may not know me, I'm Jay Spence, one of many of Madhu's friends. Heard from a few people about how many friends he had, and I can attest to that. He had many friends. I haven't known him all that long, so I think it was 2006 or 2007 when he was with the Voluntary Purchasing Groups. We met in a client consultant relationship. So he reached out to his regular consultant for some air permitting work, and he was too busy. And Madhu asked him, "You got anybody else that could help me?" And they gave him my name. Madhu called me one day. I'll never forget it because it changed my life. Started doing work for Madhu as a consultant. We immediately hit it off as friends because we had some of the same passions, and those being music, food, Oklahoma Sooners, and the Dallas Cowboys primarily. So he and I shared a mad passion. I was raised an Oklahoma Sooner fan, and as Srini said, my whole family, my wife and I ended up going to Texas Tech. My son went to University of Texas, my daughter went to OU, we've got nephews from A&M, so we've got the whole Big 12 South covered pretty well. But being a strong Sooner fan, and Madhu and I shared, we went to games together, we went to Bedlam one time together, I'll never forget. We shared that together, and somehow I just feel like he was involved with the Cowboys' first round pick last night, taking CeeDee Lamb for their first pick from the Oklahoma Sooners. So that was that was a blessing to see, for sure. Madhu was one of a kind, true friend, has been, I'll just echo what other people have said. I think Raghu and Srini, y'all touched on his sensitivity. I think his emotional intelligence, that showed in Madhu always. Family, friends, he had the biggest heart for everything. He like everybody said, want to take care of people, just provide for them. So because of that, he had a large network of friends. And I don't know what to say about family. Once Madhu and I became pretty close, he left VPG, went back to work for the family business. We shared clients. He referred clients to me. I referred clients to him. I would come up to DC for the Cowboy games, and again, the family just pulled me in, and it's been a blessing to get to know all of y'all. I do feel part of the family, and I thank you for that. Madhu will be missed, obviously. Santi, thanks for sharing the voicemail on your phone. That just reminded me that I'm gonna miss those messages I get all the time from him, or used to get. Even though his name's in my phone, we've been friends for so long, the message I always got was, "Hey Jay, this is Madhu. What's going on, brother? And give me a call when you get a chance." So I'm gonna miss those messages. I'm gonna miss our lunch. We had at least once every two, 3 weeks. The football games, the concerts that we went to. Yes, Madhu, you'll definitely be missed. We love you, and may speak for all of his friends that may be on Zoom or just couldn't be here, either up in D.C., Pittsburgh, California, or here in Dallas. We love you, brother, and you will be missed. So just thanks for the opportunity to come up here and share my experience with Madhu. It has forever changed my life. It's been a blessing for me and my family as well. Thank you.
person who's going to say a few words is going to introduce girlfriend Karen.
Didn't think I was going to get an opportunity to spend a little time to talk about my life with Madhu and my opportunity to have spent the past 3 years. I've known Madhu, his son. Our friendship started many years ago and developed into something very special. Like Jay was saying, the network of friends, obviously his family. I've been very, very blessed to have been touched and part of your family. And for those that are out there, we talked so much about his generosity, the love that he gives people, and so many words that are in my mind and sayings. You know, he had so many quick one-liners. The most important thing that I want all of you to know, all of his friends, I know everyone out there on Zoom, that his generosity, his love, his kindness was something I was never ever thought that I would ever have in my life as a friend and more. And not only as the love of my life, my best friend, he gave me the most special time in my life, experiences that I've never had, and the opportunity to feel true love and passion. And we already know about his passion for everything, his family, the love for everyone, his friends, his cowboys. Madhu's been my passion, and he will be deeply and greatly missed.
Thank you, Karen. So we're going to go ahead and proceed with the religious ceremonies. And Ravi? We're looking for Kavita.
I just want to tell a few things about Madhu. And first of all, thank you for Srinivas for letting me share a few things. And he has spent last few weeks tremendous time with physicians here and talking to doctors over the phone and spending sharing a lot of things that Madhu has been in the hospital, almost for 4 weeks in Presbyterian Hospital in Plano, and he has been talking to me. And but anyway, at the end, Mamila Shanti Srinivas, thank you for trusting me and asking me several times to take care of Madhu and help him, and I tried my best to do whatever I can, but I wish I could have done more. And I'm cousin of Madhu on Atheya's side, whoever don't know me, Kavita. You all have heard about Madhu, a lot of things, and I came to know today a lot of a few things about Madhu, and it looks like Madhu has spent his life, everything he enjoyed, and he had good life, free life, and spent everything that he can. Let me share a few things about what I know about Madhu. When he moved to Dallas, I think he did whatever. When did he move, Srinivas? 12 years. So 12 years ago, he started coming to see me for the last 5-6 years. And he used to come and call me whenever his asthma was flaring up. And he used to come and ask me, Kavita, I need my inhaler. And he was a smoker. And first thing I used to say, Mother, you need to quit smoking. And he used to say, oh, that I know. But just give me my inhaler and I'll be fine. He never used to tell me anything what he wanted to do or what he needs to do. And you all know he loved to drink. And I used to start telling him what he needs to do. I know what I need to do, Kavita. Give me my inhaler, I'll get out of here. So probably I saw him like once or twice a year. And so let me, Atheya used to call me and, Kavita, please help him. He's in a lot of pain. And he had a lot of arthritis in his neck. As years are going by, last 2-3 years, he started getting deteriorating in his health. And his neck pain started getting worse. I think last 2 months ago, or three months ago, he came to see me. That was his last visit. And Atheya called me and she said, Kavi, you need to see him. I called him, he didn't answer my first call. Then I called him second time and he answered me, and I said, Mother, you need to come and see me. And Mom is worried. And he came, and I was very surprised the way Madhu looked. And I did complete physical on him. And I said, Madhu, you're looking really bad. You need to get some labs and the workup. He complained, the main complaint he had was about his stomach and his severe burning in his stomach and abdominal pain. And I was worried, but my diagnosis, clinical diagnosis with him was possible pancreatitis. And I talked to him about it, and I said, Madhu, I'm going to get you an appointment with gastroenteritis, the gastroenterologist, and you need to go ahead and get your blood work done. I saw him sitting at my lab in my office, and I was in and out of my exam rooms, and I was looking at him, and he was sitting at my lab, and then he was gone. For a week, I did not erase my, remove his name from my pending labs, and I did not receive his labs. And I called my lab tech and I said, what happened to Madhu Mandava's labs? I did not receive them. And she said, Dr. Mulmala, he never did his labs. So I called him and he never answered my phone. And I did three phone calls and he never answered my phone. And and I think weeks went by, and I received a phone call from Srinivas saying that he was admitted in the hospital. And then Athaya said that he was really sick, and things went downhill. But whenever he came, two people he always worried was about he always worried about Athaya and Maya, and he always talked about Kash, and he loved Kash. And Madhu is a very sensitive person, and he always had anxiety in his eyes, and he coped with his anxiety, he coped with alcohol, and you all heard from everybody. Everyone said that he loved, and he's such a loving person. I never talked to him other than in medical side. I can see in his eyes that he's a very caring and very loving person, and he cared about everybody, and very good at heart. I wish I could have done more. Today I learned from all his friends and family that how many people he had good friends. I wish I could have done more in his life. I didn't know that he did have so many friends, but he did care for his family, and he worried about his son and his parents, and he wanted to do more for his parents. But he did look really, really sick in his last visit, and I checked his prostate, and he was worried about his prostate. And I said, Madhu, you need to worry about your pancreas, not your prostate today. That's what I told him. Thank you, Srinivas.
Shayananda Shashwata Shri Vishnu Loka Pratyatham Bhagavan Mukholasa Utkranti Godanam Karishi Gavam Angeshu Tishtanti Bhavanani Chaturdasha Tasmadasyaha Pradanena Ataha Shantim Prayachami Pashantim Prayachami Granti Godanam. Just finish the Sankalpa. Granti Godanam. Now starting Kalasha Puja Pukshana. After that is the Karna Mantra. Next is the Havan and everything, the production and everything. Now starting Varana Puja.
Om Imamme Varana Sude Hava Madhyaja Mridaya Vamo Surataje Tattva Jami Brahmana Vantamanas Tadasha Aste Ejamanu Hagibhi Ahedamano Varane Havodhyar Jum Samana Yipramoshi Asmintalase Jalajipatim Varanam Jayami Varana Janamaha Idamasanam Samarpajami Varana Janamaha Om Shambhakaya Vimahe Pasha Hastaya Dhimahe Tanno Varana Prachodayadu Asmintalase Varanam Jayami Varana Janamaha Idamasanam Samarpajami Varana Janamaha. Padayoho Patyam Samarpajami Hastayoho Arghyam Samarpajami Mukhe Achamaniyam Samarpajami Snanam Apohishrama Yogubaha Tana Bhujya Dadhatana Maherana Yachakshade Yavasavadamo Rasaha Tasya Bhadya Deyanaha Vishadirava Mataraha Tasma Arangamamavo Yasyakya Yadangadha Apo Janasuddhodakasmanam Samarpajami Panantum Tadundar Payami, Astrakam Akshatani Vivastra Asusanandiravim, Stiga Puyamanaha, Abhichandra Hattakayo Hirnyaha, Jeswa Nadu Odeus Astrakalanga Payami, Ignor Vidam Paramu Vitam Prajana Padehe, Yatsaharan Prasta Adu, Ayisham Kriyam Padam Jusukram, Ignor Vidam Paramas Tudeja, Ignor Veda Dakshadan Samat Payami, Dantham Dantadwarangara Dharsham. Nityapustham Karishani Ishvare Gum Sarva Bhutanam Tam Yopakvayasthiyam Gandham Dharayandasyavre Kshadani Samarpajami Pushpai Akshade Pudiyam Hamurana Yamaha Prajedase Namaha Om Shurubhine Namaha Om Apam Pataye Namaha Om Akaravahana Yamaha Om Tirtha Raja Yamaha Om Jaladhipataye Namaha Varana Yamaha Nana Vidavarmala Patra Pushpani Akshatani Samarpajami, Phalanivedayami, Phalanivedayami, Om Swaha, Om Swaha, Devadabhya, Phalanivedayami, Swaha, Pani, Swaha, Jnani, Swaha, Udhani, Swaha, Samana, Swaha, Madhya, Madhya, Pani, Yadi, Samastha, Upacharam, Samarpajami, Samastha, Jhrambakaya, Vidmahe, Pasha, Hastaya, Dhimahe, Tanno, Varanaha Prachodayadu Suvarna Divya Mantra Pushpum Samarpajami Samarpajami Varana Yamaha Idhastan Praveshayami Varana Devata Bhyurmaha Idhastan Praveshayami Varana Devata Prasada Palasiddhi Rastu Om Yena Deva Pavitrena Atmanam Prate Sadaha Tena Sahasra Dharena Avamanya Pundamam Raja Vittam Pavitram Tripadodhyam Mirmayum Tena Brahma Vidovayam Putam Brahma Pumimahe Purvota, Evanguna, Visheshana, Visistaya, Visistaya, Asya. अस्याम पूर्व संकल्पित प्रकारेण कर्ण मंत्र विपर्ण गोत्रस्य मधुनामदेस्य मम पितुः मुमूषोः प्राणो उत्क्रमण काले सुखो उत्क्रमण सिद्ध्यर्थं चित्त विभ्रम विभ्रम परिहार द्वारा श्रीमन् नारायण स्मरण पूर्वकं श्री वैकुंठ प्राप्त्यर्थं कर्ण मंत्र जपं करिष्ये। गंधद्वारान्तराधर्षां नित्यपुष्टान्तरीक्षिणीं ईश्वरीं सर्वभूतानां तां योपक्वये श्रियम्।
Family members and friends, me and my husband convey our thanks to all of you coming in to say goodbye to my dearest baby Madhu departure. And thank you all.
Thank you all. Okay. We really appreciate it.